Hey guys, Denver with you here. We have a special video for today where we try to solve a question that I've had for years. Is it possible to color grade on an iPad? Now, I'm not talking about simply using it as a control surface. There's already apps that do that, but I'm talking about being able to grade directly on the iPad with an Apple Pencil and do it inside of Adobe Premiere, DaVinci Resolve, or Final Cut Pro 10 on the Mac. You can kind of think of it as grading on a Wacom tablet, but on the image itself. For the past 10 years since the iPad was first introduced, I dreamt of being able to touch an image and change its exposure and colors with a quick gesture on the image itself without it being overly complicated. You see, the native tools aren't always intuitive, and they do require that you take your eyes off the image to adjust some arbitrary control to just make a change. But I thought, why can't color grading be like painting or sketching? So naturally, we wondered about that with Cinema Grade, since it already allows you to color grade directly on the image with the mouse and adjust things like exposure, saturation, color temperature, and even perform some secondaries. So what about on the iPad? I mean, it's an amazing screen, and with the Apple Pencil, it just seemed like color grading would be a dream. So we decided to give it a try with the latest macOS version, Catalina, and turn on the new Sidecar feature. Then what's really cool is that the Apple Pencil actually doubles as our mouse. Now we'll apply Cinema Grade to our clips as a plugin, launch Cinema Grade, and move it over to the iPad. Let's see how this works. You can see that we have a bunch of clips from our timeline showing in Cinema Grade, and our Apple Pencil is functioning as our mouse. You'll see I can make this full screen. Now the first tool that I was absolutely excited about exploring is the vectors tool. With it selected, we can just tap over an area of the image that we want to change, such as the sky, and then drag up or down to modify its color. Then by holding down the shift button on the iPad, which I thought was pretty cool that it had this, we can then drag to adjust the saturation for that color. And with the command button and dragging, we can adjust the brightness of the sky, giving it more of a dramatic look. Isn't that amazing? To me, this is a dream. We can keep tweaking things, like giving the skin tones some saturation, and maybe giving the flowers more of a warm look. You can see how fast and easy this was. Let's see the before and after. Now that's pretty cool, but let's see how this holds up when doing a correction of a scene from the ground up. Here in our next clip, we have a log image that's looking really flat. To add contrast, we'll select the contrast tool and drag up and down. To fine-tune the exposure, if we choose the shadows, midtones, and highlights tool, we can literally place a point in the shadows and then drag up to bring in more detail. Now, what's happening here is Cinema Grade is intelligently selecting the right tools for us based on where we select. And we can see those changes over here in the inspector. For the bright areas of the image, we can place a point on the clouds and drag down to restore their detail. Now that brought down the exposure on our talent, so I'll place a point on the skin tones, which automatically selects the midtones and adjusts them. Now, if we were to use the traditional controls, we'd have to know which area of the image that we wanted to correct. We'd have to go find the right tool, such as the black slider or shadows wheel, and take our eyes off the image all while doing it. Moving on to white balance. The color temperature is looking a little cool, but by selecting the color temperature tool, we can drag down to cool it down, or up to warm it up. I think that looks better warmer. Moving on, you can see that we could use some more color, so I'm gonna go ahead and choose the saturation tool. We can drag up or down to add just the right amount of saturation. Finally, to perform some really cool secondaries, in other words, change specific colors in the image, with the vectors tool selected, we can tweak the colors of the sky by placing a point on it and dragging up to give it more of a teal color. and maybe bring out some of the saturation with the shift modifier. Now let's say we want to change the season a little bit and make this look a little more like autumn. We can click on the foliage and then just drag up to warm up the greens more towards orange. Now, if we were to try to do this with the traditional tools, it would require placing points on the hue versus hue curve to isolate the sky and the foliage and then drag those points. But you can see that's more time consuming to do all of that. Now, one thing I will say that I have found as a drawback is if I want to open the small drop-down menu for each of the tools, it does require a long tap, and sometimes it's not as responsive as I'd like it to be, requiring a couple of taps before it reacts. Sidecar is a new feature, and I'm sure Apple will improve its responsiveness over time. But I have discovered that I actually prefer and can work much more quickly by leaving my left hand parked on the keyboard and using the hotkeys to select the tools. What's really convenient is the hotkeys are intuitive. For instance, C is for contrast, E is for exposure, W is for white balance, and so on. So I think if I were to color grade all my projects this way, I'd use a combination of the hotkeys and then work on the Apple iPad with the Apple Pencil, again, kind of like a Wacom tablet. Okay, so after we've color corrected our hero shot, we can jump to the shot matching page and organize the footage into groups. Color coding the clips will allow us to organize our clips by scene, and then we can match the clips together by each group. This works really well on the iPad. Once grouped, we can tap Match Shots, then copy our base correction from our hero shot to the other shots in the group, saving us tons of time. We can then tap these arrows here to cycle through the clips to verify that they match. And if there are any mismatches, for instance, this clip looks like it has blown out highlights, we can just place a point on the clouds and drag down. There, that's a better match. This other shot here is a little underexposed, so we'll just bring up the exposure. All right, looking through these one more time, I think that we got it. So we're done shot matching. If we need to, we can always go back to the group section to create new groups or modify the ones we already have. Now we get to the really fun part of color grading, and that is adding a look. We'll go to the final grading page, and I was really excited to see how the iPad would perform in displaying all the different looks and LUTs. With two fingers, we can scroll through the looks and LUTs that we can see previewed as thumbnails until we find the right one. I really like the look of this Tetrachrome 400 film, so I'll tap on it with the Apple Pencil to apply it. It looks too strong for my taste, so we can open up the inspector and dial back the intensity with the mix slider. Of course, we can continue to make creative tweaks to the shot, but what's really cool is that this same look gets applied to all the clips in the group, again, saving us tons of time. Let's toggle our grading on and off so we can see the before and after. Doesn't it look awesome? When we're done, we'll just tap apply, follow the prompts, and now our grading shows up inside the editing software. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. So my conclusion is, I would say all in all, it was really fun to explore color grading on the iPad. And I feel like we've never been closer than we are now to color grading being like painting or sketching. There are some drawbacks with responsiveness and being able to select the right tools, but with Cinema Grade, combined with the latest advances from Apple, this makes it possible. So tell me, what do you think? Is this the future of color grading? Let me know what you think in the comments below. And if you'd like to try this out for yourself, you'll find a link to Cinema Grade in the card above and in the description below. You can try it out with a free 7-day trial and explore tons of other features like the false color feature for nailing the correct exposure and the X-Rite chart feature for performing automatic color corrections. Well, this has been fun. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you'd like more videos on color grading, on how to get your films to the next level, click the subscribe button and then the notification bell to be alerted of the next one. Until next time, enjoy the rest of your day.